Hi, I hope everybody's doing well. I come on here real quick to share a dream that I had a few nights ago. I've been kind of not wanting to share it because, I don't know, it's just because it's not exactly the most upbeat content, but I know I have to share it. So, Lammy is going to, Benjamin here is going to be your host. And because I don't want to be, right now I'm not wanting to be in front of a camera, so I've been cleaning and cleaning up my car, and so I'm not exactly ready for your viewing pleasure. But Lammy is, and he's more than happy to oblige. So anyway, we'll get right into it. All right, so I went to like a shelter place for the night because it was getting down in the 20s, and somebody said that they had a church open or something, and so I went. And before I went to bed, we were talking about God, and you know, me and this other woman, and you know, just a couple of the things that are going on. Not really too deep into it, but you know, just kind of briefly touching on some stuff. And I had the hardest time going to sleep for different reasons, but anyway, when I finally went to sleep, I had a dream. And the dream, I can't, and I'll be honest with you, usually when I'm dreaming something from the Lord, I usually can see it real well. But in this dream, I don't remember so much of what I seen, but what we were saying. So, you know, I can't really give you a real good description of what the place looked like. I knew that we were in a prison of some sort. Now, you know, what kind, I'm not really quite sure. But it was me and some other women. I'm thinking maybe like four or five other women. And one of them, I'm not going to say who it was, but it was somebody that I know of. It's not somebody I really know personally. Okay, so, but anyway, we were all Christians. And we were all in there, and we were talking about how, you know, we knew while we were there. And in the dream, we were discussing, you know, we knew that this was not good that we were there. We knew that there was something that was, you know, probably going to happen to us. So we were praying, and, you know, we were reading the Bible. And that's one thing, though, is that we did have Bibles. So they somehow, they allowed us to have them or something. I don't know. But we were reading, and these women knew Scripture. Like, they completely knew, you know, what we were, where we were at in time. And, you know, they were awake. And so we were all discussing how we were going to resist. We knew that they wanted us to comply with this thing, you know, which we knew was the mark. And they were wanting us to comply with it. And I was telling them that if they complied with it, that, you know, that, and they, you know, and they were like, yeah, we know, we can't take it, you know. And so, like, but I was saying, look, they're going to try different techniques to try to get us to do this. And so we have to not, this is what I remember saying to him, you can't listen to devils because they'll lie to you. And so when they start talking, you have to tune them out. That's what I said. And I said, so when they come and they start taking you off, you know, when they start doing this to us, we have to get it in our head that we're not going to listen to what they say, because when they start talking, and if you, this is what I said in the dream, I said, if you listen to them, you will be deceived. And so we cannot listen to what they say. We got to tune them out, cast down what they're saying because it's not true. And, you know, and they're like, yeah, you know, and everybody's, so we're all in agreement, you know, we're all praying and everything. And then they come and get me and take me somewhere. I'm not sure where they took me, to process me or something. I don't know. Because I don't even remember where they took me to. That's why I said it's kind of a strange dream, because the only thing that I remembered was when they brought me back. And I come in, it's like a holding cell thing where we was. And they had a totally different look on their face. And I go, what's going on? And they go, we took the mark. And I go, what? And they go, yeah, as soon as you left, they came and told us that they was going to kill us. And so we just went ahead and took it. And I was like, you did what? What? I mean, I was just freaking out, right? So then I was, okay, so after, I mean, of course, I was extremely sad and just bewildered that here these ladies are. They knew the Word of God. They knew the times we were in. They knew why they were there. Okay, they said they understood that, you know, what they said was going to be, you know, deception and everything, but yet they still took it. So I don't know, you know, you can take that to God or whatever and, you know, to for yourself and, you know, see if he gives you anything on it. But what I gathered from it, you know, when I woke up was that there's going to be people, apparently, who are going to end up in this situation who are going to know, they're going to know the right things, but they're, for some reason, one way or the other, I don't know why, they're not going to be able to do it. So that's what I gather from it. Now, there's all kinds of reasons why I thought about that might be, which is maybe they didn't have the Holy Spirit. I don't know. I'm not going to try to speculate too much on it. I'm just going to try to give you what, you know, what was in the dream, and then you can try to, you know, figure out what you think it means. And if you have any information, or if the Holy Spirit gives you anything about it, please leave it in the comments for me, because I'm not really sure how to interpret that, other than the fact that, you know, we can't listen to what they say if you find yourself in that situation. So, but anyway, I hated to share it because it's just not a very upbeat thing, because, you know, it's not one of them things that I like to share, but I know I need to share it because it might help somebody. So anyway, I just thought I'd come on and share that. And then I, like I said, I woke up, but the feeling that I got in the dream when, after, you know, the initial shock and bewilderment of the fact that they took it, was that now I'm here alone. You know, I mean, not alone because Jesus is always with you, but I mean, I was the only one left out of the group that had not taken it. So I just started to pray, and but I remember feeling really alone. In the sense that, you know, and then not knowing how they're going to act, you know, since they already took it, and just different things. But I don't want to get too, like I said, I don't want to get too much into, you know, what I think about it and stuff like that. But that's just how I felt. That's what I experienced. And that's what we were saying. So I thought I'd come on and share it. And I just hope everybody's doing okay. And please pray for me, because I'm being super attacked. Not so much today, but yesterday was horrible. Like, literally attacked. Beyond unbelief. I mean, just unbelievable things. So if you could pray for me, please, to not fall back into sin cycles because of it, because it's really easy to do. And because I'm all alone, and it just, you know, it just is. So please pray for me, and I'll continue to pray for you guys. I love you guys, and if you have any, you know, dreams that you've had recently or anything that you want to share, just leave it in the comments. I love you. Peace and grace to you. Be aware, be alert, and beware. Okay? I love you guys. Bye.